Imagine a front wing that is designed to produce downforce, having sections that actually produce lift as well. Of course, this would be completely counterproductive, counterintuitive. However, a Formula One car's front wing nowadays do not merely produce downforce. It is also used to influence aerodynamic downstream, with air going past the frontal area of a Formula One car where the front wing would be, and then guide this path of air to other section of an F1 car, looking to fully utilize this airstream. Generally, a Formula One car's front wing produces downforce. The Y250 Vortex, and before 2019, it played a critical role in producing as much outwash as possible. This was banned by the FIA after 2019 on grounds that it made overtaking more difficult, citing an increase in weight by a leading car starving a chasing car's aero devices. This makes it more difficult for a chasing car to get closer to a leading car for a planned slipstream and then overtaking maneuver. After 2019's new regulations on the front wing, many teams have their own way on how they would design the front wing to influence the rest of the car's downforce. There were designs that tried to recover lost ground on outwash, like Red Bull Racing. There were those that compromised, namely Mercedes-AMG, McLaren, and those which focus a lot of pressure buildup center on the front wing with a shallow outer wing trim, like Alfa Romeo and Ferrari. Red Bull Racing's second team, then named Toro Rosso, used this design as well, different to their main team, obviously experimenting. 2020, however, a pattern began to emerge. All the other teams are moving towards the Alfa Romeo Ferrari-style front wing, as their wing saw the outer section running less trim, while the inner section more trim. This is a sign that pressure buildup or release in this region is even more important. It is also here that it has a primary role in creating the Y250 Vortex. A Vortex that, even after so many years, still plays a pivotal role in influencing a Formula One car's aerodynamic downforce. The Y250 Vortex is generated by leading edges on the inner corner of a front wing. The front wing element's inner tips are designed as vortex generators rather than to produce front end downforce. The larger dimension of those tips would mean a stronger vortex can be created. They are important because this vortex helps drag more air downwards and outwards to enhance downforce aero devices of a Formula One car. This particular front wing design, with its pressure difference on the inner section of the wing much more apparent, may be chosen for being able to generate an even more powerful Y250 vortex spiral than the other wing designs. Assuming this is the case, here we will look at a possibility in generating an even more substantial force for an even more powerful Y250 vortex. Creating lift on the same structure that is producing downforce will definitely increase total energy of a wing without changing the amount of downforce. A direct consequence, of course, is an increase in drag. The offshoot would be a front wing that could be set up follow downforce without sacrificing other aspects that is demanded by the aerodynamic package, and in this case, to consistently produce strong Y250 vortex, or a vortex that is even more powerful than with a regular front wing that is on full downforce settings. This yin and yang plus minus effect can also be used to control other aspects of the wing's performance. Here is an example of a low downforce front wing. Notice the inner wing has lesser edge, pitch and forward dimension that would create lesser of a vortex. Here is a high downforce front wing of contemporary design with longer edges, more pitch and larger forward dimension that can result in producing a more substantial vortex. With the counterforce design, the inner wing is consistently producing a powerful vortex, whether on low downforce or high downforce, as the inner wing dimension is always there or thereabouts at maximum pitch. came across this Alfa Romeo front wing picture while looking to compile material for this piece. Chances are they are doing this to influence the outer front wheel wake while also contributing to generate a more powerful Y250 Vortex. The outer front wheel wake can also be used to influence the inner wheel wake's path.